Welcome to the World Register. The World Register is an independent news source providing truthful, unbiased, and timely reporting about people, places, and events. Reuters News Agency reports that the Uzbek immigrant accused of killing 8 people by speeding a rental truck down a New York City bike path told investigators he was inspired by watching Islamic State videos and began planning Tuesday's attack a year ago. Saifullo Saipov, 29, said he felt good about what he had done and asked for permission to display the flag of the terrorist group, Islamic State, in his hospital room. According to the report, Mr. Saipov is charged with one count of violence and destruction of motor vehicles causing the deaths of 8 people, and one count of providing material support and resources to a foreign terrorist organization, the Islamic State. The maximum penalty for the first charge is death. The maximum for the second is life in prison. It was not understood from the report if the suspect will be charged with terrorism. One American News Network reports that a Spanish judge has ordered that Catalan secessionist leaders to be held pending a potential trial over the region's vote for independence. According to the report, a European arrest warrant for ousted Catalan President Carles Puigdemont has been issued. Spanish Prime Minister Mariano Rajoy sacked President Puigdemont and his government last Friday, hours after the Catalan parliament made a unilateral declaration of independence. The vote was boycotted by opposition parties and declared illegal by Spanish courts. Catalan political parties and civic groups denounced the decision to jail the legitimate government of Catalonia and called for protests outside the Catalan regional parliament at 7 o'clock p.m. local time. And as reported by Reuters News Agency, senior U.S. Republican and Democratic lawmakers proposed targeted sanctions and travel restrictions on Myanmar military officials. According to the report, the legislation would reimpose some sanctions lifted last year as Myanmar returned to democracy. It would bar the United States from supplying most assistance to the country's military until it has been certified that alleged perpetrators of atrocities against the Rohingya are being held accountable. The measure does not target Burmese leader Aung San Suu Kyi, head of Myanmar's civil-led government and a Nobel Peace laureate, who still enjoys strong support among some U.S. officials. More than 600,000 Rohingya Muslims have fled Rakhine State in Buddhist-majority Myanmar, mostly to neighboring Bangladesh, since security forces responded to Rohingya militants' attacks on August 25th. A fact check performed by India Today showed that widely used images purportedly showing Rohingya Muslims in Myanmar burned to death is a fake. According to the report, the picture is from a 2010 fuel truck disaster that happened in Congo and is not of Rohingya Muslims. A fuel truck overturned on a Congo highway and exploded, killing 220 bystanders, including many who were watching a cricket match in roadside shacks. Although Reuters mentions that the United Nations has denounced the events in Myanmar as a, quote, classic example, end quote, of ethnic cleansing, the news agency failed to report that the official position of the Myanmar government is that the Rohingyas are not recognized as a national race and are illegal aliens from neighboring Bangladesh. Previous reports also state that the Myanmar government is waging a campaign against Muslim terrorists who have been attacking and setting fire to villages of Buddhists and other non-Muslims.